When you're in a rush, but you really want to get this update posted, this is Beauty A to Z Update 1. I'm a little bit pressed for time, but I at least wanted to get this intro filmed so I can show you guys this beautiful, colorful look. If you're new here, hi, how are you? Thank you for stopping by. Welcome to the family. My name is Rose. I'm a girl boss on a budget who loves to save money and project pan. Today's video is my first official update for Beauty A to Z. This is a PANtastic Ladies collab. The creators of Beauty A to Z is Jessica Lee and Amanda D. I will, of course, have them linked down below in the description box for you guys, as well as the PANtastic Ladies Facebook group. I did want to state I was in such a hurry this afternoon. I'm on my way out the door to go to work, and I was getting ready and grabbing some dinner because I do work second shift, and this happened. I ended up ripping one of my acrylics off. It was totally on accident. That's why I'm still here. I have the time to at least get this intro filmed and going. The wonky finger right now, it is what it is. If you see this, that's why I had to put it out there, because I'm sure you're gonna see this big old band-aid on my finger. What the objective of Beauty A to Z is, you pick products to match each letter of the alphabet. For example, the letter B, you would pick like blush or bronzer or benefit. For the letter C, you would pick cream, blush, or something with the letter C in the word of the product itself, as long as it is incorporated into each item somehow, but whether it be the name or the title or the product brand or the product color, then it is acceptable. I know everybody is doing this kind of tailored to their own way, whether it be just working on a few numbers of the alphabet at a time, or working through all 26 letters at once, which is how I have decided to do it, kind of just doing a free-for-all, working through all 26 letters of the alphabet at one time. I'm not making this a rolling project. How I have decided to do my updates on this, since I am technically working on 26 items at one time, which is a lot of products, I have decided to do my updates on this bi-monthly. Instead of doing monthly updates, I'm doing my updates every other month, just so that a way it gives me a little more time to actually use the products, to get enough to see any type of progress on them. Without further ado, let's just go ahead and we will hop on into the video and start with the letter A. I'm sure you're wondering why I look different, totally different outfit, totally different eye look. One thing that still remains the same is this dang nail that ripped off. That was a couple days ago, you guys, and I thought I would at least do the intro and the outro to this video for you guys, just because I really enjoyed my eye look that day, and I knew I wouldn't be able to get the whole video, but I wanted to at least do those two parts. I wanted to briefly mention to you guys that earlier in on this project, right around the time when I first started it, I have to look down at my notes, you guys. I changed two of the letters. Letter A, which was my Kylie Apricot lip liner, I changed it instead to my Kylie lipstick in the shade Almost Friday, which it's still an A. I also changed the letter L, which was my L'Oreal Blush Please. I changed it and put in instead my ColourPop lip liner in the shade BFF. I just wanted to mention those two things to you briefly. We have a lot of products to get through here. I did manage to hit 3 goals so far, leaving me a total of 23 products left to get through, which is still a lot. If I have photos of any of the products with progress on them that I feel is worth showing you guys, I will make sure to pop them up on the screen. Let's go ahead and start with the letter A. That was my Kylie lipstick in the shade Almost Friday. It is just a really pretty pink lipstick. I am getting a little bit of usage out of it. I started wearing down the letter K because it has her name on it. I did make a tally of this, so let's go ahead and I will show you and we will find out together if there is any progress on this since it has been a couple months. As you can kind of see, there is a little bit of progress there. So let me go ahead and fill in the difference and that way I can come back and show you guys. As you can see, there is a little bit of difference and it's probably the tip of it that actually got busted off somehow. Hey, it's still progress, right? Whether it was accidental or whatever, it's still a little bit of progress. I have been using this, not a whole lot, just because I'm doing so many different lipstick projects. I do have a lip service project that I've been doing here on my YouTube channel. I will list it in the cards for you guys if you want to go check it out, as well as a lipstick roulette only on my Instagram I've been doing. So I'm doing a lot of lipstick projects. For the letter B, I went with my Physician's Formula Bronze Booster. I set the goal on this to finish it. If I have any photos or if I see any type of progress worth showing you guys, I will be sure to insert some photos. Especially like on the powder products, I will show you photos. As you can see, it is a baked formula. It has the waffle pan in there, and I do have a very healthy pan on this product. So I would like to hopefully finish this up within the year. We shall see. I've been using it almost every day. For the letter C, I went with my Flower Beauty Cream Blush. I set the goal on this to finish it, which is... it could be an achievable goal if I would just use it more. I haven't used it too many times. As you can see, there is the marking from where I started at. I'm just going to leave it right there because I haven't used it but a couple times since then. I have a year to get through these products. I just need to really try to focus a little bit harder. I don't feel that it's even deserving of a new line yet. I'm going to really try to hone in and focus on this a little harder for the next couple of months. For the letter D, I went with my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Little Mini Powder in the shade Diffused Light. I set the goal on this to finish it up as well, and I do have the dome of it worn down very nicely. No pan yet or any type of crazy progress on this, so we will keep working on that. For the letter E, I went with my Maybelline eyeliner in the shade Glazed Toffee, and this is just a really pretty brown eyeliner. I really do enjoy a brown liner in the waterline from time to time. I do have a marking of this. It's not really worth showing. I haven't used it at all this month. The progress on this is going to be the same as it was. Some products I haven't used yet, other ones I've really been trying to focus on, but at least I have 3 goals met so far. For the letter F, I went with my Maybelline Fit Me Pressed Powder in the shade 100, which is translucent. I set the goal on this to hit pan. No pan yet. There is a really nice dip in the pan, and you're starting to be able to see the ring of the pan just a little bit. I'm hoping by the next update on this project, I will have the pan. This is a really great setting powder. I always use this to clean up any type of contour or down my nose. This is really all I use this for, but I really enjoy it for that. For the letter G, I went with my Milani Glitter Eyeshadow in the shade Luster Light. I set the goal on this to use it 1/3 of the way down. As you can see, there's the progress line from when I started the project. I have used it a couple few times. As you can maybe kind of see, if I zoom you in and do my editing correctly, I will mark it right now to show you guys where the line is now. That's a little bit lower, but not nothing too crazy. the starting line, and then here's the new line. And the reason I had to basically do it on the opposite side is because that's the only place where I can see the visible progress. It's not one third of the way down yet, so I'm gonna keep working on this, and hopefully by another couple months or so, I will have used this one third of the way. For the letter H, I went with my Flower Beauty Luminous Heat Wave Bronzer in the shade Sun Swept. The cap is broken. I set the goal on this to finish it up, which is just an unrealistic goal at this point, you guys, just because I haven't used this at all yet, because this is more of my summer shade coming into summertime. I'd already have been halfway through the project, so I'm gonna change the goal on this right now to just hit the pan, because there's no way I'm gonna finish this. It is another baked formula with the dome, but the dome has been worn down. I used this every day last summer. I'm just not gonna use this until summertime hits. I don't know why I put it in the project. I'm gonna keep it in the project. I'm just gonna change the goal on it to hit pan. I'm sorry that my phone keeps going off, you guys. I have to keep it on for work purposes. I'm on call 24 hours a day, so I have to make sure I can hear that phone at all times. So I do apologize if you hear it going off in the background. Letter I went with my It Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Illumination Concealer in the shade Light Ultra Fair. This is actually really, really light, you guys. I just thought it was the shade Light. I did not realize that it was Ultra Fair on top of it, because this is way too light. I've really been struggling to even use this. I have gotten some use out of it. I just have to mix it with other concealers. I set the goal on this to use it halfway. It is a nice concealer. It's just way too light, so it's going to be a challenge, especially as the spring and summer comes around. I'm only going to get darker, so we shall see. For the letter J, I went with my J Cat Prismetal Eye Mousse in the shade Champagne Whiz, and I set the goal on this to hit the pan. No pan yet, but it has definitely gotten some use out of it. If I have any photos, I will show you from last month's progress to now. I have used it a couple times. These are really, really beautiful on the eye. I just need to reach for it more often. No pan yet. For the letter K, I went with my e.l.f. 24K Rose Gold Highlight. I set the goal on this to hit the pan. I use this quite often, and it doesn't even look like the embossing is wore down, but it is, looking at it in person, which is so crazy how the camera does that. Looking at it, I mean, of course the edges are round. I'm not flicking you guys off either. Around it, there's still embossing, but in the middle, looking at it, I've done very well at getting it wore down. This is a really hardly pressed highlighter. It is hard to get the product up off the pan. What I have found, how I've been doing it, is I use a little spoolie on the end of my eyebrow brush, and I will literally have to just scrape it to loosen it up, and then I pick it up with the brush and apply it. But it does make for a beautiful highlight that way. Without doing it this way, the product won't come up. Actually, this is an exact dupe for the Natasha Denona's Tan Bronze and Glow Palette Highlight Shade, which I have right here. And I just wanted to show you guys a side-by-side comparison. Look at that. What do you guys think? That is that not an exact freaking dupe for this shade right here, which is the shade called Glow Impact Powder? They are identical. And I put this one on this cheek, and I put this one on this cheek, and you cannot tell a difference whatsoever, you guys. Even this is the same thing, and it's very hard to pick up the product out of there for some weird reason. I thought I would share that with you. So no pan in that yet. For the letter L, I went with my ColourPop lip liner in the shade BFF. I set the goal on this to use it up, which that might be a unrealistic goal. We shall see. I did mark it at the beginning of the project, so let's see how much progress I have made, if any at all. Look, you guys, I have made some progress on that. That is so impressive. It's only been a couple months. It's still progress. progress. I don't include the tip down on any of my tallies ever, just because once it gets down to here, I don't use it anymore. That's it. You ain't getting no more out of that. Let me go ahead and fill in the difference so that way you guys can see a little bit better. As you can see, there is the progress that I have made. Not a whole lot, but it's still progress, and I'm very excited about that. I'm using this in conjunction with my other ColourPop lip liner in the shade 951. That is actually a part of my past, present, and future project pan. I will link that in the cards if you want to go check it out. For the letter M, I went with my Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. I set the goal on this to finish it up, and this is my first goal met, you guys. I finished this up. There is nothing left. There's nothing coming out. I'm very excited about that. This is the first goal of the three goals that I have met so far. How I have been doing this is it's not a rolling project. Once I start hitting goals, I'm just going to continue working on the rest of the products in this project, because there is a lot. 26 is a lot of items. For the letter N, I went with my NYX Epic Ink Liner. I set the goal on this to finish it up as well. I'm still working on this. There is still product in there. And usually how I determine that these are done is just when they stop performing. It's still working as of now. For the letter O, I went with my Catrice One Drop Coverage Concealer in the shade 03 Porcelain, and I set the goal on this to use half. I haven't used this but a few times since the intro to this, so there's the line. It's still basically there. I don't see any visible progress to mark it. Again, this is kind of light. It's too light for me, so I've been struggling, and I haven't really been wearing concealer a whole lot lately, you guys. For the letter P, I went with my e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer, and there is three P's in there, and I hit the goal on this to hit the pan. I actually just hit the pan today. As you can see, there is a little peeping pan in there. Not nothing too crazy, but it is a pan. And if I have photos from when I started this, I will be sure to insert it to show you the progress. There is pan. I hit my goal on this. This is a really nice primer. I'm just glad that that is another goal met, even though it's just a little pan in there. I still will continue to use this, just not for the project anymore, because Lord knows there's a lot more products to get through. So that is another goal met, and I just hit that goal today. For the letter Q, I went with my e.l.f. Cream Contour Quad. I set the goal on this to finish any shade that I hit pan on. There's two pans in there, but I have not used this at all, you guys. I've really been struggling just because I have another cream contour that's in this project that I'm working on as well. So I don't know why I put this in the project even. I guess because Q was a hard letter. I've just been really struggling with this. What I have decided to do is I'm going to roll this out right now. I'm going to go ahead and roll in to replace it my Inky List Q10 Serum. And there's the letter Q for Q10. This is actually really, really beautiful serum. I use this in the mornings and in the evenings. Just a pea size amount goes such a long way and absorbs into the skin beautifully. I do really enjoy this serum, and I already have it marked. It is about almost finished. As you can see, I'm about right there. I've used a lot of this. I just feel I could be better, and I will be better at finishing this up. I'm gonna set the goal to finish it off. I know I'm not gonna use this cream contour quad anymore, especially while I'm trying to work on another cream contour quad, which is the Huda Beauty Tantor one. For the letter R, I went with my Revlon Ultra HD Lip Polish in the shade Birthday Suit. This is another goal that I hit. I set the goal on this to use it 1/3 of the way. It's going to be virtually impossible to show you guys any progress. When I pull the thing out and I look inside of there in the light, I can see I have used quite a bit of this. I use this almost every day. I'm wearing it right now. It is just a beautiful shade, and it makes it, it's like a your lips but better shade. And these are absolutely stunning. I am about already halfway on using this. I will definitely be able to finish this up, no problem. I hit my goal of using this 1/3. That's one less product as well in the project. Those are my three goals that I hit. For the letter S, I went with my ColourPop Super Shock Shadow in the shade Frog. I set the goal on this to hit the pan. No pan yet. I have used it a couple times, but nothing too crazy. We'll keep working on that. For the letter T, I went with my Huda Beauty Tantor, which is another cream bronzer. And I set the goal on this to just make a dip in the product. Looking at that right now, there's a nice dip in there. That's what I set the goal on, is to make a dip in the product. Actually, I could probably call this goal met right now. So that is actually 4 goals out of the 26 products. Not bad at all. That will leave me 22 products left to work on, which is still a lot of products. I really do enjoy this, but that's the goal that I set. I thought I maybe set goal to hit pan, but it just says make a dip. So that's the dip. There's definitely a nice dip in there. For the letter U, I went with my Urban Decay Heavy Metal Glitter Liner. I set the goal on this to use it halfway. As you can kind of see, there is my progress from when I started. So let me go ahead and mark it right now so that way you can see better where I'm at. There is my new progress line right there. Slow and steady wins the race. I use this quite often to kind of put either all over my lid or to line my cut creases with, and it just makes it for a really beautiful look. We are almost done, you guys. We got a couple more letters left to go. The next letter is the letter V, and I went with my NYX Vivid Brights Liner in the shade Vivid Sapphire. I set the goal on this to finish it, which I know I'm not going to finish this in the year's period of time just because I don't use it that often. So I'm going to go ahead and change the goal right now to just use it halfway, you guys. I set too much of an aggressive goal on a few products, and I just want to be more realistic with myself, especially since I know I haven't been using this very frequently enough to where I know I can finish it in a year's period of time. I'm just gonna set the goal to use it halfway. For the letter W, I went with my e.l.f. Wow Brow Gel. I set the goal on this to finish it up. I still have product in here. I've been using this. I still have a little ways to go on this. It's got the fibers in it. It's a really nice brow gel. Still working on that. And then for the letter X, I went with my CoverGirl Vitalist Healthy Elixir Foundation. There's an X in the word. I set the goal on this to use it halfway. As you can see, there's my marking when I started, and here's where we're at now. So I am so close to halfway. Let me go ahead and mark it and show you guys, and we might have another goal met right now. There is my new line. As you guys can see, you can see through the bottle all the way around. I don't know if I could say that is halfway or not. It definitely looks like it's halfway. It's very, very, very close to halfway. If not, I mean, it's right on the word elixir all the way around. I'm gonna go ahead and call this goal met as well, because I set the goal to use it halfway, and that is halfway, maybe a little above. I'm just gonna go ahead and keep working on it. So close on that one. Two more letters left, you guys. Oh my God. For the letter Y, I went with my YSL All Hours Concealer, little sample foil packets. I set the goal on this to use ivory and natural right here. And as you can see, I haven't even opened these yet. I should probably try working on these in the next couple of months because these will probably be easy to hit that goal on. And then last but certainly not least is the letter Z. And for the letter Z, I went with my Essence Melted Chrome Eyeliner in this shade Zinc My Way. I set the goal on this to use it halfway. I haven't used this one time yet, you guys. Those are all of my 26 products for Beauty A to Z update one. Briefly, let's recap and I will show you the four products that I hit my goal on real quick. That was my Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. I set the goal to finish that up. My Revlon Ultra HD Lip Polish in the shade Birthday Suit. My Huda Beauty Tantor in the shade Light. My e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. Those were all of my 26 products for Beauty A to Z. We will come back in another 2 months from now towards May, every other month, and I will come back unless I happen to hit and reach goals on any of my products in this project. I will then do an update as I reach goals, but until then, I'm going to try to just keep it every other month so that a way it's not such an overload on my schedule. We will be back in approximately a couple months to check back in with you guys. What I did for my look today. My Violet Voss Sugar Crystals palette. This is part of my first week's rotation palette for Throwing Shade. I will have that listed in the cards for you guys if you want to go see how I got this palette chosen. This is for the first week in that project. I created this really fun look with this palette. What do you guys think? I think it came out really beautiful. It screams springtime and just fun and beautiful. And you guys know I love my colorful looks. What I ended up doing for my look is I used a little bit of this shade Banana on the inner portion of my lid and then just went right on down, starting from here down. And then I went in with Mint Cocoa and mixed it a little bit with Blue Raz. For the outer V, I just blended in Jelly Bean and then I cut my crease and I used these two yellow shades right here, Lemon Drop and Buttercream on my lid, as well as Pearberry on the middle portion of my lid. The outer V of my lid, I used Grape. And the lashes that I'm wearing are Coco Lashes in Jolie. Is everything for this video and for this update. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And until my next video, everybody enjoy the rest of their day. Bye. Finger, I can't help but to laugh about it.